This is the sick list of 8 people Hillary was found with after her associate was found dead. This is Beyond Disturbing by Prissy Holly for freedomdaily.com. It's truly startling, the massive trail of dead bodies that keep accumulating around Hillary Clinton, as this crooked swamp wench will kill off anyone who tries to spill the beans on her dirty little secrets. Cross this woman and you're likely to get suicided with a double tap to the back of the head, as Hillary comes under closer scrutiny for her dirty dealings with the Uranium One scandal. The timing of yet another death becomes extremely suspicious, given her track record for conveniently making people disappear who are about to implicate her in another scandal. Now, an extremely disturbing list has just been produced of all the mysterious deaths that Hillary has been tied to just since last year, as the total death toll swells to over 60. Number one, Steve Mostyn. Several weeks ago, ex-DNC chair Donna Brazile revealed how Hillary rigged the Democratic primaries against Bernie Sanders and how she believed that Hillary was behind the unsolved death of DNC staffer Seth Rich. Brazile said she feared for her life and worried she'd be killed next, and took additional measures to protect herself by installing a security system in her home and would pull the blinds to thwart off the snipers. Now, on the heels of Brazile's startling revelation, it's just been reported that a Democratic mega donor and Houston attorney, Steve Mostyn, has just been found dead, where, true to form, the man's death is being ruled a suicide. That's not surprising. Mostyn had once been close to Clinton, but their relationship came under severe stress back in 2015 when an ethics watchdog group, Foundation for Accountability and Civic Trust Fact, filed a formal complaint against Clinton and her campaign for illegal coordination with the Ready for Hillary super PAC. Mixed Politics reported the timing of his death is disturbing given the fact that Clinton had once again found herself at the center of scrutiny for alleged dirty dealings during her time as Secretary of State with the Uranium One deal, in which she and her foundation were paid off to approve a deal effectively turning over 20% of our uranium deposits to the Kremlin. Joseph Mifsud. Just last week, a well-known professor mysteriously vanished without a trace from Rome, where no one has been able to locate him at his work or place of residence. Joseph Mifsud was at the heart of Hillary's dirt. Claim went missing without a trace, leaving a trail of questions. Mifsud disappeared last week and hasn't shown up for work, where he teaches at the University of Rome, according to one of Mifsud's colleagues. He had recently declared that he had compromising material on Hillary that would serve as the missing link between Hillary and the dirt the Russians had on her. CNN reported Joseph Mifsud, the Maltese academic suspected of being a link between the Trump campaign and Russian officials, was once a regular on the foreign policy circuit, attending conferences the world over. Now, after being identified as a key figure in the U.S. special counsel investigation into Russian influence over the 2016 U.S. presidential election, Mifsud has gone to ground. Now, there is the third journalist, Daphne Caruana Galizia. Several months ago, investigative journalist Daphne Caruana Galizia was behind the massive leak of 11.5 million documents called the Panama Papers that revealed how a Panama law firm helped some of the richest people from around the world establish offshore tax havens on Central American country. This illegal scheme allowed crooked politicians like Hillary Clinton to avoid paying taxes, as they'd simply stash massive amounts of cash in Panama. But Galizia would never have the chance to testify about the investigation or what she knew about Hillary. The investigative journalist was blown to smithereens after a rigged car bomb detonated just moments after she drove away from her residence. Immediately after news broke of Galizia's horrific murder, alarm bells around the world immediately went off, with political pundits immediately labeling Galizia's death a political murder. Shocking doesn't begin to describe this, journalist Mark McAuliffe wrote, where it's believed that Galizia was blown up by a bomb that was being remotely controlled and detonated by an IED. In the weeks leading up to her murder, Galizia had told authorities that she was being constantly harassed and threatened with her life. ABC News reported Caruana Galizia had been sued for libel because of various articles she wrote on her blog, running commentary, and she had filed a report with the police 2 weeks ago that she was receiving threats. Monday evening's parliament session was scrapped, except for briefings about the bombing scheduled to be given by Mr. Muscat and opposition leader Mr. Delia. Number four, State Department and federal agent Kurt Smolik. Back in August, State Department and federal agent employee Kurt Smolik's decaying corpse was pulled from the Potomac River. Smolik was hot on the trail, exposing Hillary's ties to Pizzagate, as well as her ties to human child trafficking ring in Cambodia. Cambodia is a country that is infamous for their human trafficking, child sex trafficking, and child sex tourism. The location where Smolik was stationed was a hot spot of this type of illegal activity, and it's possible that he had been privy to some damning information on Hillary Clinton. Yet another state employee is found mysteriously dead, his body pulled from the Potomac after being reported missing. One investigator stated that this is related to Pizzagate, as possible ties to the child trafficking and the criminals behind the numerous emails and fraud-related mysterious deaths. There are clear links to overseas child trafficking hotspots, recent mysterious deaths related to the DNC, Clinton email scandal links to Clinton State Department. Number five, Lord Jacob Rothschild. In what's being reported as a freak unfortunate private plane and helicopter accident where the two aircrafts collided midair, leaving four dead, is far more mysterious than is being said based on who was on board and is now dead, Amanda Shea from M Political previously reported. What makes this collision strange, outside of how it happened, is that it took place right outside the Rothschild estate, and only three of the four victims have been named. It's been speculated that Lord Jacob Rothschild is among the casualties, and if true, this could be really bad for Hillary. So far, the only victims to be identified, perhaps on purpose, is the pilot of the helicopter, Captain Mike Green, and a student and flight instructor aboard the Cessna. How many people told me how to pronounce this? 18-year-old Savan Munday, who was being instructed by Jasper Barha, according to The Sun. So was Jacob Rothschild, with a very big connection to the Clintons, the fourth victim. Several sources seem to suggest that's the case, but the Rothschild estate has not confirmed nor denied Jacob's well-being. Sean Lucas, we're all aware of him, was one of the unfortunate souls to find himself murdered after he was the attorney who served the DNC with a lawsuit last year that proved that Debbie Wasserman Schultz worked with Hillary to rig the primary election against Bernie Sanders. The complaint was served right before Wasserman Schultz resigned amid the WikiLeaks email scandal on July 24th, less than 1 month after Lucas served the DNC amid the WikiLeaks email scandal on July 24th, Lucas was found dead in his bathroom, where the cause of death is still pending, according to the medical examiner's office. Seth Rich, which we are all familiar with, savagely murdered July right after WikiLeaks with some very disturbing dirt on Hillary. Several weeks later, WikiLeaks would release thousands of emails related to Hillary, but Rich at that point was already dead. After leaving his Northwest DC neighborhood early Sunday morning on July 10th, Rich was savagely shot multiple times before the shooter fled the scene, leaving zero evidence for authorities to solve the murder. Barrington J. Wissanant Jr. After Lucas's untimely and mysterious death, another attorney by the name of Barrington J. Wissanant Jr. is believed to have taken over the case against the DNC and Hillary and had been working in recent months on exposing Wasserman Schultz's fraud and visa case in Florida. But just like Sean Lucas and Seth Rich, who died under mysterious circumstances after getting too close to Hillary and the DNC's dirty secrets, Wissanant's life has just come to an abrupt end. His body was just found washed up on a beach in Hollywood, Florida, and investigators have absolutely no explanation for how he wound up dead from trauma to the head. These are chillingly only the recent people to mysteriously die just since last year. The list below of 54 other deaths will absolutely blow your mind, as people mysteriously vanish around Hillary is a clear pattern that has gone on for years, according to govslaves.com. And it goes on that date back to 1997. It was James McDougal, Mary Mahoney, Vince Foster, Ron Brown, Victor Razor II, Paul Tully, Ed Willey, Jerry Parks, James Bunch, James Wilson, Kathy Ferguson, that was in 1994, 1993 for James Wilson, Bill Shelton, 94, Gandy Baugh, 1994, Florence Martin, Susan Coleman, Paula Grober, 1992, Danny Casolaro, Paul Wilker, and this was 1980 October surprise, was found dead on a toilet on June 22nd, 1993. John Parnell Walker in 93, Barbara Weiss, 96, Charles Meisner, Dr. Stanley Hurd, Barry Seal. And the list, you know, you can go on with this list indefinitely. You can take a look for yourself. The following persons had information on the Ives Henry case, and it's dated back to 1988 and 89 and 90. And the following Clinton bodyguards are dead. You can't even count how many. And world-renowned space econ Molly McCauley, John Ash, Victor Thorne, Joe Montano, Klaus Uberwin, a man who sought Clinton's emails from Russia. Russian hackers committed suicide. Stephen Mostyn, major player in Hillary's inner circle, suddenly commits suicide, and it goes on and on. So now these are the recent ones within this year here, and how she gets, you know, it's like, it's mind-boggling how these things have taken place, and yet nothing has been pointed out. And it's a shame, young guys. Now with the Rothschild, it's not verified yet, but why wouldn't they just come out and say that he's fine and he wasn't on the plane? What's the big secret? This lady here, Daphne. I mean, the list goes on and on. This one, I just did the report on Miss Fudd, that he's missing. It's not quite verified yet, but why would he go missing? Wow. It's frightening. It's frightening. And all this, and you know, look at her. No care in the world, and she's walking around scot-free. It's such a shame. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below, and again, thank you so much for watching.